One of the most important concepts that I share with patients who have invasive breast cancer is the fact that after the cancer stops being in situ meaning inside the ducts, and starts growing through the walls of the ducts and starts shedding off, floating away cancer cells, once that process begins, we know we have to treat the whole body. And so even with early breast cancers, is there a potential that those early cells, as they float away, can go to other parts of the body, set up shop, and be what we call distant metastases? And the answer is yes. Now, in general, the more favorable the grade of the tumor and the smaller size of the tumor, and being the lymph nodes being negative and being estrogen receptor positive, and all the sorts of things that put a breast cancer sort of on the good side of the curve, in general, that worry of cancer setting up shop in your lungs, in your liver, in your brain, and your bones is less of an issue. Doesn't mean it can't happen. Doesn't mean that even with the smallest cancer, that shedding off early can't set up cells elsewhere in the body that, particularly in estrogen receptor positive breast cancers, we don't find out about for 3 years, 5 years, 7, 10 years later. How these cells get out into other parts of the body and potentially lie there dormant is a real focus of research about the environment in which cancer cells are living in, if you will, elsewhere in the body. A lot of research is going on now about inflammation and processes in the body that increase inflammation, including a life stressful sort of event like the death of a spouse or husband or close friend or a child or traumatic things like that. So cancer not only involves the cells that are shed off or the cells in the local environment in the breast, but also the environment, if you will, that the cells are occupying and living in. So I've made this point many times. I'm going to make it again. When you present with an invasive breast cancer, we're talking about, in most cases, having to treat the whole body. The most common thing for at least 5 years in estrogen receptor positive breast cancers is an anti-hormonal pill. And then chemotherapy is about treating the whole body as well. We've talked repeatedly about what the indications for chemotherapy are. So yeah, unfortunately, from the earliest times, there is that potential. But what's the good news? The good news is, the smaller the cancer, the earlier it's detected, the lower the grade, the fact the lymph nodes are negative, all those positive things, the chance of that happening is certainly much smaller. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.